Truma, makers of the combi heater and iNet system, are proud to sponsor Practical Motorhome TV.
Welcome to Practical Motorhome TV, your one-stop shop for buying, owning and getting the most from your motor caravan. I'm Niall Hampton and in this series we have a fantastic package for you. Motorhome and campsite reviews, accessories roundups and friendly expert advice from our resident expert Diamond Dave. I'm off to Loudhams in a minute to have a look at a Swift Contiki 669. And after that, we're going to be visiting Bath Chew Valley to find out why this particular site has won more awards than seemingly any other. But in the meantime, I cast a critical eye over an end kitchen two berth, the mighty also sleeper Stanton. Are you in the market for a top quality coach built with Mercedes underpinnings? Well, you're in luck and you don't have to buy German. Not saying for one minute that that's a bad thing. Well, thanks to the venerable British manufacturer Autosleepers, you can have all the above and made in Britain, a fantastic coach built on a Mercedes Sprinter base. Let's have a look at the Stanton, a sub 6 meter end kitchen two berth. Now you have to admire the honesty and practicality of the end kitchen layout. It does exactly what it says on the tin. You come in through the door here and the kitchen is on the rear wall facing backwards. You've got pretty much everything you need. Dual fuel hobs, separate oven and grill, sink with mixer tap, and here on this side, a microwave very sensibly mounted at chest height, and under that, the Auto Sleeper's trademark, the cut glass crystal glasses. And there's one other function I really like, which is used for serving. You just pull out this worktop here, and you can serve your guests food when it's ready. Alternatively, were this the designated party van, you could be stood on the other side, serving your guests drinks without letting them in to the living quarters. And there's also a tip-up flap for extra serving space, and that's next to the dual fuel fridge with separate freezer compartment. This sociable parallel lounge is a great place to hang out and spend time together. There's plenty of illumination from a roof light, two large windows on the side of the vehicle, ably supported by four LED spotlights. You'll notice also that the fabric scheme is different to the standard Auto Sleepers package. This is Catalan, introduced for the 2016 season alongside the more established Moonstone. Now this is less busy on the eye and has been wildly successful. In fact, I can't remember the exact proportion, but it's very impressive indeed of the people that have taken this alternative scheme. I really like it. It goes very well with the cabinet work, which has this two-tone effect going on with this little inlay where the handles are. It's very Germanic, the reassuring click it makes when you close these overhead lockers. Very satisfying. Now the sleeping arrangements here are very easy to use. A sliding slat space pulls into the middle of the gangway and you rearrange the cushions in time-honoured fashion. It's a nice double bed and you will have a very good sleep. You also have the option of adding a double bed in the overcab section. Now this test van is a low profile unit with the panoramic cab skylight. If you didn't want that, you can switch to the Luton, which allows you to pop a double bed in there, making the Stanton a proper four berth. And talking about the cab, there are absolutely loads of great toys to look at in the Mercedes Sprinter. Now, if you're lucky enough to come into one of these from a Mercedes car, then you'll think you've died and gone to heaven. It's a fabulous cab with everything just where you need it. And just listen to the sound the engine makes. Very good. You can almost feel that quality. In case you're wondering, it's a 163 bhp unit with automatic transmission and it meets the latest Euro 6 emission standards. Pretty good in anyone's book. There are also blackout blinds here in the cab. Something I haven't seen for a while is an ashtray in a little drawer like this. Very good indeed. On the other side, there's also a meter that tells you the condition and level of your LPG gas tank, which has a 25 litre capacity. And in case you're wondering, the gas is one element of the heating system that will basically give you all year round touring because this van is grade 3 certified. Now there's some innovation, but of a very different nature, going on in the washroom. I like this folding section for the sink and vanity unit, which is basically acting as a barrier between the shower and the loo area. Very good indeed. There are a couple of other pleasing features on the outside, starting with the canopy awning. Very nice on a day like this. There are also connections for electricity and gas on the outside here. And you can also access the under seat storage space from this hatch, which also has a recess for the canopy awning's handle. Very good attention to detail there. But perhaps the thing I like most of all is this handy wet locker here, so you don't have to take your muddy wellies into your van. The auto sleeper Stanton is 5.94 metres long, so it will definitely fit on most people's driveways. Its MTPLM is 3,200 kilograms with a payload of 351 kg. Now, as tested, this van is 63,495 because it has a few extra bells and whistles on it. Real prices start at just under £60,000 on the road. So I know what you're thinking, it's an expensive price for a two-berth end kitchen van when many other options are available on the market, including from auto sleepers on a Peugeot Boxer base. But let me just make this point. A few years ago, my dentist tried recommending a particular brand of electric toothbrush. I balked at the price, but he said to me, it may be expensive, but it's quality. And that is what I would say about the Stanton. It's a particularly fine van.
Open all year round, Bathtew Valley Caravan Park in the hamlet of Bishop Sutton in northeastern Somerset is a relatively small site with just 45 touring pitches, but it's perfectly formed if you're looking for a quiet place to stay in attractively landscaped grounds. It's open to adults only, which should ensure plenty of peace and quiet, and boasts some of the finest luxury bathroom suites we've encountered on a campsite. No wonder it's a multiple winner of the annual Top 100 Sites Guide.
We're Bathtew Valley Caravan Park. We're a 45 pitch adults only touring park located in between Bath and Bristol, Wells and Cheddar. We've been here since 2004 and it's been in the family since 1998.
All pitches are hard standing with some fully serviced and there's powerful 16 amp electric hookup, while members of the two main caravanning clubs can enjoy a £1 per night discount.
As the only 5-star park in the county, we have a wide variety of facilities. Our washrooms are very popular. They're in the style of ensuite shower rooms, so each one has an external door with its own shower, sink, loo, hand dryer, hair dryer and a shaver point. And because it has its own external door, you're in a completely private room, separate from any other guests. One of the washrooms is also disabled adapted, so it has bars for support, low level sink and a wheelchair accessible shower.
A lengthy list of facilities, including a large lending library, a free internet kiosk, a dog walking space, free clothes drying and ironing facilities, and a complimentary freezer service.
We have an acre of woodland, which we planted in 2006, with a variety of walks through it, with nature-themed exhibits throughout. If the weather isn't as sunny as you might hope during your stay, there's lots to do in the area. Both Bristol and Bath have got large shopping centres, as well as cinemas and theatres. For motorhome owners, we also provide a hire car from reception, which is available by the hour, so you can take it out in an evening just for an hour or two to go to a restaurant, which is just £4 an hour, or you can have it for a longer period, such as 6 hours during a day is very popular, which is just £15.
That's my first time here at Bathtew. The facilities are very, very good. You always judge a caravan size on the facilities. I mean, the toilet block is spotless, including the disposable waste unit is very, very clean. Probably one of the best sites I've been on for a long, long time.
For some people in the market for a luxury motor caravan, only an imported model will do. But they don't really need to do that. You see, we build some stonking vehicles right here in Blighty, and one of those is certainly the mighty Swiftcon Tiki Black Edition. The 669 is an 8.5 metre long tag axle 4-berth based on the Fiat Ducato. It's got a raft of amazing features inside and out, starting with these twin awning lights, this rather large awning, and that's because it's going on a rather large van, loads of external storage options, and myriad external connections. Now, normally when commenting on a lounge, you have to be sitting down, but here in the Contiki, there's masses of space, so I'm standing up and somewhat enjoying it. And I'm also enjoying the ambience of the lounge, overlocker lighting supported by spotlights, a window on either side, and the gloss locker facings, Hessian inlays, chrome handles. In case you're wondering, the finish is called Arely Sen. Down here we have a very nice comfort provided by the seats, which at the moment is in travel mode. I can make that into seating mode by adding a couple of cushions just to fill that gap straight down there.
Now
Now this driver's cab is proper Gucci. It features plenty of things you just don't see very often, like these bronze infills around the radio. This lovely leather steering wheel with these chrome details that match the chrome surrounds on the instruments, a very pleasing touch indeed. This van has Fiat's Comfortmatic transmission, another great thing for people that just love comfort on the road. But perhaps one of the things I like most of all has to be this tablet holder that comes up from the dash. How good is that? Flick it up, drop the catch on the side to release the restrainers, and you can keep taking your tablet. Now, another reason not to forget your tablet is that you can use it to select certain services on the van by interfacing with Swift's command control panel via an app you can download. It won't control the water though. You still have to do that yourself. Now, this kitchen has an outrageously good specification and some fantastic materials used to build it. I'm loving this surface here, it's really nice. You can rub your hands on it for hours. Moving along, you get the dual fuel cooker, 3 gas rings and 1 electric hob, a microwave oven, separate oven and grill, and on the other side, a fridge with a separate freezer compartment. And next to that, you have the washroom, which is split into 2 discrete spaces. There are 2 double drain holes in the shower floor, which will go nicely with that Eco Camel Orbit showerhead that will give you a very good spray. Next to that, closed off by means of a bifold door, is a predominantly wooden space where you will encounter a half-length mirror, vanity unit, and swivel loo. Now, the rear bedroom is certainly spacious and very comfortable. I'm on the first level and I can still almost stand up, which says great things about the headroom. Ambience is good, with a window on either side, overlocker lighting again, and a few task lights, even a couple of speakers that face inwards so you can enjoy your music or audio to maximum. And the roomy fixed bed gets the benefit of a duvet mattress, a Swift Group exclusive, and I know what I'm doing as soon as I finish this review. There's also a wardrobe flanking the bed and a couple of overhead lockers up above. Now, if you're wondering about this, so am I, but I suppose you can say it does match the headboard. The Swift Contiki 669 will set you back £72,890 on the road. Now, I know what you're thinking, for that kind of money you could buy an imported A-Class, but why would you really want to do that when you can have something with a habitation door on the UK near side and is also as good as this? Now, with an MTPLM of 5,000 kilograms, you're going to need C1 classification on your driving license to be able to drive it, but you do get a payload that's just shy of 900 kilograms. Now, at just over 8.5 meters in length, you're going to need somewhere quite substantial to store this, unless of course you can sneak it onto the front drive at home. But that would seem a bit of a shame, because surely with something as well equipped as this, you'd want to be out touring all year round.
Hi, I'm Dave Newell. Welcome to my workshop. Air suspension is an increasingly popular addition to motorhomes. It can improve ride quality, stability, even the load carrying capacity of the vehicle. Air suspension basically consists of a pair of airbags that mount between the rear axle and the chassis, and they take part of the load off the springs. One of the problems with motorhomes is, because they're almost always close to fully loaded, they are full of furniture after all, the suspension is very often half compressed and onto the bump stops or auxiliary springs, which gives them a harsh, crashy ride. By replacing those bump stops, auxiliary springs, with air bellows full of compressed air, we can give a bit more compliance to the suspension, take away some of that banging and crashiness, but increase the stability of the vehicle at the same time. You can have full air suspension, which replaces the entire suspension system, or you can have auxiliary suspension. The auxiliary system is what we're talking about today, with just the bellows between the axle and the chassis. The systems can be inflated either manually using a bicycle pump, foot pump, 12 volt compressor, or even a garage forecourt airline. Or you can have a built-in compressor with a control panel on the dashboard, so you can inflate or deflate the bags at the touch of a button. So let's have a look at an installed system on a vehicle. This here is the original bump stop or auxiliary spring. This is the part we remove to replace with the airbag. The airbag clamps to the chassis here with this bracket and to the axle here with this bracket on the bottom. The airline pipes come in underneath and we clamp that to the handbrake cable so that it flexes nice and gently with the movement of the suspension. That then runs through and in protective trunking down to the front of the vehicle where it enters the cab. The pipes come in to the driver's doorstep area where they connect to one of three means of inflating the system. We can have a basic two valves, one for each airbag. They're simple shader valves, just like your car tyres. So they can be inflated with a bicycle pump or a foot pump or a 12 volt compressor or even a garage forecourt airline. You obviously need a pressure gauge to be able to check the pressure in the bags with that system. This would be the next option, which is a single filling point, two valves, one for each line, and a gauge, so we can check the pressure in the system easily. To inflate the system, simply turn the two valves on, take the cap off, attach your compressor or foot pump, just as before, and this time we can read the pressure on the gauge so we can see exactly what pressure is in the system. This would typically mount on the driver's doorstep about there. The two air lines come into these two points, one for each side, just through a couple of small holes drilled in the back of the step liner there, and that gives you a nice convenient filling point and pressure checkpoint. So those are the basic filling systems. There is an alternative, which is a built-in 12 volt compressor. We have the control panel for one just here. This switch controls the compressor, and these two valves allow us to deflate each side individually. So that's the basic auxiliary air suspension system, including its three options on inflation points and the 12 volt built-in compressor. Perfectly viable system to fit yourself, as long as you're a competent DIY mechanic. Pay attention to the usual safety precautions, use axle stands, don't crawl under an unsupported vehicle, chock the wheels so the vehicle can't roll off the stands. Do it on solid ground and level ground. I hope you found this helpful. Enjoy your travels.
The Selex is Bilbo's best-selling conversion on the VW Transporter. We've gone a couple of steps extra though by bagging ourselves a long wheelbase version, which is 5.29 metres long. As you can see, it's a very exciting van with a side-opening roof and loads of other added extras, including on this one, the 150 PS engine. So let's have a look inside and see what specification sets this one apart from its rivals. There are many campervan converters in the industry who use the Volkswagen Transporter as their base. Bilbo's is one of the better established ones, having been going since 1977. It has a great reputation for build quality and innovation. Its vans are a very pleasing place in which to spend time. As you can see, there's an emphasis put on storage, the three overhead lockers in the kitchen here that not every other converter offers, and also down here. We also have a Waco compressor fridge, 65 litres, where most converters will stop at 50. And you have a grill, fantastic. You don't get that in some of the more expensive foreign offerings. And also a sink and a pair of gas burners next to it. And if you're looking for the automatic ignition, you won't find it. Bilbo's prefers to give you a little clicker to use instead. Now, surely the test of any good camper van is how easy it is to make up the sleeping accommodation in the evenings. And I think this one is no exception at all. In actual fact, it's very intuitive once you've done it a couple of times. First of all, we take out the armrest on the left here, and then we turn our attention to the headrest. These shake out. Just use a little bit of brute force to get the whole process started. And once it's out, it's out. Do the same with the second one. And here comes the clever bit. We have a lever here that we pull towards us. And we pull on the seats. Down they come. All we need to do now is to put this little filler cushion in this section. And hey presto, you have a super comfortable double bed. Now, I've overnighted in this van and I had a very good night's sleep, thanks in no small part to the Webasto heating, which runs off the diesel supply to the van. Very even temperature throughout the night, and I was warm and toasty. Another interesting thing is in the pop top are the ventilations at the side. You just have a couple of little screens just to hook under a little rail. Very easy, no zips involved. And that was a really good thing too. I woke up in the morning, there was no condensation in the van. The other thing, and you really feel the benefit of the long wheelbase variant, is the amount of space you have here. When you wake up in the morning, you can sit on the end of the bed, plenty of place to dangle your legs while you're making your coffee. Open the door and enjoy a terrific view. What's not to like about that? As part of the T6 upgrades, new engines have been introduced. They're Euro 6 units, which meet the latest emission standards. Now this test van has a 150 PS unit fitted, which is a cost option of just under £3,000. The standard lump is 100 PS. Now elsewhere, the facelifted T6 cab is a very pleasing driving experience all round. Excellent switchgear, great driving position, and the usual safety and driver assistance. Our test van also has USB and SD card connectivity, so you can take control of the music and audio you're listening to, making a long drive less of a chore. I think it's fair to say the Selex makes the most of the storage opportunities at the end of the van. This shelf here can actually be lifted out, so you can put bulky items there. And there's also a sliding partition at the back of the seat bench. And if you slide that to one side, you can push through long items like skis, fishing rods, planks of wood, flat back furniture, whatever you want, right into the bowels of the van. Pretty good touch indeed. You also have some services action going on at the back here. Your gas locker is there, and then your water input is there, right next to the wardrobe. Not the biggest wardrobe you'll ever find, but you will get a few coats in there and perhaps a few other items too. As tested, this Bilbo Selex LWB will cost you £50,665. It's 5.29 metres long, and I really think you feel the benefit of the extra centimetres inside the vehicle. Obviously, you're going to need a driveway long enough to put it on, and if you don't mind parking something that's slightly longer, no problem. This could be the way to go. Now, Bilbo's is one of those converters with a very loyal following, and it's been in the game a long time. It gives customers practical solutions to what it knows they really want, rather than a long list of added extras they think might be desirable. And I think that's what sets them apart from many of its competitors. The T6 base vehicle is brand new with a Euro 6 engine. And even though the conversion has been around longer than the new variant of the Transporter, this winning formula is going to be around for a long time yet. Sadly, that's all we've got time for on this week's show. Next time, we'll be looking at the wonder of inflatable driveway awnings, plus the Rapido 665F. In the meantime, you can keep in touch with us via practicalmotorhome.com or Facebook or Twitter. Until next time then, tour safe and take care.
Truma, makers of the combi heater and iNet system, are proud to sponsor Practical Motorhome TV.